On TBA tonight, a memory of the tension and excitement as a small high school prepares for the big game of the year. Basketball. A film by Don Shabib.
For me, for this coach, there's only one sin that you can commit, and that's to play without passion. I don't want boys that don't feel deeply about winning. I don't consider winning the ultimate end, but I think that unless they can, at 18 and 16, can play a game with fierce passion and desire, then I don't want any part of them. The basketball really is secondary. The individual, the young man, is first with me. And so I think, you know, any success that I might have in basketball or baseball probably is due is that I think I can get a lot out of young ball players. And I probably get a great thrill out of helping young people develop in all aspects, not only basketball, but in their lives as human beings. This is the championship game, and everything in our schedule has been geared to this. If we don't win this year, chances are that we won't win for quite a few years because our school is very small. If we don't win, not only the students, but the whole community will be disappointed in us. Frogs up here. It seems more like a rock and roll revival than a high school pep rally. But that's what the name of the game is. Make a lot of noise. And we certainly hope to hear it tonight. This time I'd like to introduce the members of our team, the ones that are here today. Some are getting haircuts for their big show tonight. And I'd like to start off with our center, Big John Schmidt. Yeah. One of our guards, he calls himself the handsomest basketball player in the school, Art Rutledge.
I don't really consider basketball everything. If they can talk to me about a soliloquy in Hamlet, or the beauty of Shakespeare's language, this to me is so important. And this is tremendously satisfying. Whereas I'm just not a basketball coach who knows about a 3-2 defense or how to pick a guard or things like this. I don't think this is important in the long run. They become rounded human beings, and I hope that I am in some way responsible for this.
One mistake, Hazel.
Oh, no.
I'm very hurt. A mythical dollar bill. If you could give me the word for hostile. Within 3 seconds, John Smith, 1, 2, 3.
Inamikis.
You lose. Inamikis. Okay.
I would get upset if I was just a comedian. You know, if I just came to entertain people. But I think education has to have a measure of humor and comedy about it. And once you have to impose discipline from the outside and make kids fear, then there's no education. Where is the education in that? They forget as soon as they leave the classroom. Oh, I know there's better classroom teachers than I am, but I think maybe the person that plants a thought in their mind about life will ultimately have a greater effect.
We'll see you tomorrow. Who wasn't there?
Bernie, you missed my flat.
I had to drive Bush to the city.
You had to drive Bush to the city?
Oh, what an excuse. Pathetic. Let's hear it again. What you driving for?
You didn't believe me, did you?
Hit the pennant, I'm sorry. You believe that, Dave?
Yeah.
You got that, Mary?
Please report the class to you after in the ninth period.
No fancy dresses now.
And to be a professional to me, it means to be intensely interested in young people. To me, that's the only criterion I use for teaching, how interested you are in young people. And it certainly goes beyond the classroom. It certainly goes beyond the basketball court.
Good, good! Hey, attaboy.
Okay.
You faked a nice shot. Come on, Garrett. Come on, John, go for the rebound. Good.
Very good.
Go! Larry, don't forget to step inbound. Do it again, 5 times. We want to see good timing here.
Go!
All right. All right, there's another option. Good. All right. Throw up the ball at center for the championship game. John Smith will score one. Doc will score one, and I'll score at least two. Ernie? Don't talk to the teacher like that. Here we go. Come on, get in this way.
I couldn't practice unless I was involved myself. I couldn't sit back and be a grandstand coach with a whistle and an autocratic air about me. I have to enter into it. When I had these kids in junior, I was about the best player on the team. And now I'm a distant fourth or fifth. It's been a tremendous blow to my pride. Sometimes I can't sleep at night.
When I'm with these guys, I just so enjoy life. I have a younger outlook. I'm not old myself. And I don't think I'll ever be old because I'll surround myself with young people that will force me to stay alive and try to be spontaneous and seeing life through the eyes of young people. I think it's so important. So many teachers lose this. They get old too fast. There's a measure of freedom in young people's lives that older teachers, older people don't have.
I get a great satisfaction out of boys coming along as human beings. I can see it in the course of 2 or 3 years. I can see a great improvement, a great growth in these young men. Whether I've had anything to do with it, I really don't know. I hope so. I like to think that I have. I'm not sure that I'm even responsible for them becoming better basketball players, but I'm sure that these young men have helped me immeasurably to grow as a human being.